Hello, this is Bern, and if you're interested in finding out how you can say no to a man that is set a boundary as a high-value woman, well, stick around, because I will be sharing how to do just that on my episode today. Hello, this is Bern. Welcome to your greatlifetobe.com. Today's another edition of Get the Love You Crave, and I'm very excited to be sharing with you how you can say no to a man or set a strong boundary like a high-value woman. What do I mean by that? I've seen many, many women that go through a situation that's painful, that's uncomfortable, that feels unjust, that feels icky, that feels creepy, and don't set a boundary with a guy. Therefore, the guy may repeat the behavior again and again until the woman doesn't want to see this guy anymore. Something that could have been averted had she set a strong boundary, right? That's one scenario. Another scenario is that a woman reacts so strongly and sometimes even out of proportion based on the boundary that's being crossed that the guy feels rejected or feels like this woman doesn't want me in her life and disappears, ghosts her, or never shows up again, right? So neither of these approaches is recommendable. Recommended, what I want to share with you right now is four steps. If you want to set a strong boundary that is compassionate but also firm, here's how you can go about it. Number one, I want you to separate the behavior from the person. What do I mean by that? If you equate this guy as an asshole because he's doing something versus he's exhibiting an asshole behavior, then you can be pissed at the behavior, not just the guy. And that's fundamental in being able to share with a person how to do things in a way that are fulfilling to you without making them wrong or a bad human being for making a mistake or for crossing the line, right? Especially regarding sexual type innuendos or he wants to go faster than you or something like that, being able to set a strong boundary but also not killing the person in the process when it's not called for, when it's not called for you to be super strong with someone, I think it's important. I mean, you shouldn't kill anyone in any situation, but you know what I mean. So separating the behavior from the person means that you might feel, for example, that the guy did something that you're not cool with, and instead of saying, hey, you're wrong for doing this way, or I hate you for doing this, you can say, you know what? For example, he's pushing for sex and you don't want to have sex. You can say, I really feel attracted to you. You're not rejecting him. And this is not something I do early on when I'm dating someone. And you can set, here's what I need, or needs to happen for me to have sex with someone, right? You can set your boundary and voice it in a way where you're not rejecting him. You say, you're a very cool guy. I find you very attractive. And here's my boundary, right? It's number two. If possible, say no with compassion. I say if possible because sometimes if the boundary is very strong or you're in danger, then you are gonna have to set a boundary in a strong way, doesn't matter how it comes out. But if you're in a situation where you can react more kindly because the situation doesn't call for you to punch him, right? Then I would say that say no with compassion. Be able to say no and keep in your heart that he might be nervous, that's why he might be doing it. He might not know any better. He might just be testing you, but once he gets a chance to know who you are, he might lean back and appreciate the fact that you have that boundary. So just have the possibility of saying no with compassion. Third, state your needs directly and clearly. Stating your needs directly and clearly is important because guys understand direct, unfluffy, non-bullshit language. Why? Because men connect with each other in a direct, non-bullshit way for the most part. So if you say to the guy, this is how it feels to me, or this is what I want, or this is what I expect, or this is what I would prefer, just state, I mean, you're not saying that that's what he has to do. You're just saying, if you want to continue engaging with me, if you want to pursue me, here's what my requirements are. You're not making him wrong for not doing it that way at the beginning. You're also not saying, here's what you have to do for the rest of your life. You're just saying, if you give me this, I will be much more likely to continue dating you and continue engaging in these conversations and continue exploring how we can be an item, right? Number four, focus on the long-term vision. What do I mean by that? Focus on the long-term vision means recognizing that it's going to feel uncomfortable to set a boundary. So if your rule for setting a boundary is, I must feel like I am flying on high air and I'm getting a massage at the same time, then it's very unlikely that you'll set a boundary. If you focus on, if I set the strong boundary now with compassion, I can get much more of what I want in the future, then you're more likely to forgo or not focus on the short-term pain or the short-term discomfort in order to set the boundary. Focus on what you want long-term and be willing to walk away if things are a deal breaker for you and a guy is unable to rise up or give you the respect or the time or the space that you need. Hope this is helpful, useful, and insightful in some way. If it is, I'm gonna ask you to do three things. Number one, click like on this video. Number two, subscribe to my channel. Number three, on the description of this video or somewhere on your screen, you'll see a pop-up that allows you to sign up to a webinar video that I'm sharing with you that shares how you can find your soulmate and with a lot less pain and a lot faster than you would otherwise. Very powerful stuff, absolutely free. If you have any questions for me, place them on a comment on this video. And as always, I challenge you, live a full and conscious life.